20 seconds.
Daikuri got sniped off by Nature's Prophet. He jumped in behind them. The Orchid is over on the wire, but he's already used his Yorzef to try and keep Prophet out of the fight, but Jurex will then end up dying. Where is this RP? It still hasn't come. Banesdive once again in the back lines. RP's available, but where's the group up? It's still not there. Pug has put down the Nether Ward, but it's Ember Spirit doing all the work in the front lines for OG, and Death Prophet, finally the RP will connect. He will go down. He does go down. Anna will get the double kill for it and a follow-up Searing Chains into Spectre. And they hold him in position so they can drain out the last bit of life from him.
In the meantime, the
are available for war.
Wait, what? The mid melee racks fell to a siege creep. The meantime.
Oh dear. Oh, this is one lane. They used their ultis again. Oh, that was Exorcism and Haunt.
Ferev's trying to force him to come back. Fortification's already up. It's Ember Spirit who's the one to do it. And he is looking for this kill on Nature's Prophet. This is so big because it's the dieback. Mads in the same position, a skewer forward. The trees were never going to stand. Greenpeace will shed a tear. Arthos, Arthos going to find him. As the shot's out. And into the Mystic Flare, no tell. Difficult to survive with that Spirit Vessel on him. So he just turns around into the Sunray. That's now that SP 15 plus to protect him. And Anna, he'll go for more. He's got the damage, but none again. Chrono. He has to get through the illusions. Jurax comes in with the tether to give him a little bit more life. Double gang is a little bit further forward, just trying to make sure that Alicia is taken out in this fight. No plus twos for anyone. Exotic Deer can try and hide. Does anyone else have detection? No, they don't. That Shadow Amulet's actually
hitting so hard with
needs,
the DD.
But Nisha just cannot survive. Alicia has to buy back to try and be involved in this fight. And Nisha, he'll survive. The Shadow Amulet protects him. That's the one from Exotic Deer. They don't see him. Undercover, does anybody have some kind of AoE to help him out? Nope. All right, we'll charge forward. Go off the Phoenix into the Nova. That won't be a protection. That's only death. Exotic Deer, he's bouncing up towards the Io, who can tether himself away to safety. Not to mention, Tops has joined the fight. A triple kill for Anna. They've kited this fight absolutely perfectly, OG. King, when they wanted some kind of answer, but they've got nothing. And maybe they've actually got the kill, the charge forward!
Oh my god!
They cancel the TP of Nisha! Dev was just going to the lane! Now Nisha is isolated, Io is gonna TP over to try and help out so they can actually have the life to battle against Nisha in the trees. But he's isolated. And they'll have the damage to get through him. They scan, you already know this, they are there! And Anna will come in for his extra kill. Four wasn't enough, give him five. More damage, but they don't ever have the team fights because they never had the positioning, and now they're going to lose Karkor as well. Locked inside of a Sprout, the power shot from Thompson, thanks for kill securing. They're actually going to swap in Notel, but he gets a double stun. Finger of Death off,
oh, good Karkor, Ravage.
Creates a space with the Ravage. That Blink Dagger does do some work finally, and Zebus is Sprout up with a Slide of Fissurian Chains. Anna going to town. They need to stop Exotic Deer. These spirits. The Lancers are doing too much work, and that's one way to do it. Slide a fist out. Partos is the sole survivor.
And he's
if they did this fight 10 minutes earlier, it would have...
He's still
maybe
not a survivor. No.
Okay, yeah, no. Triple kill for Thompson.
They even buy back the Venge, but it's too late, and he's TPing out. So that's just another buyback. That's basically...
Eventually.
There you go. Mickey's like, okay, my hand is farm. I want to farm. Jump in, though. Tiger found first. Caught up by the pounce. Means he can't do anything. The call in from Boxy. Can they do enough damage to Slark is a question. Mystic Flare up. The four stuff away. The RP coming in. They're forcing through with the skewer. They'll find additionals. That's quite for fours as well. Mickey looking to blink away. BKB not really teaming much. Double kill for Thompson. And the final one standing not for long. Who likes cooked chicken? They'll be able to get him quite with a buyback. But that's more or less it. And GG gets called. Alliance, they tap out.
The Tidehunter as well. At least he can crack and proc, walk away a little bit faster, but trapped inside trees. The silence of the Ventral Spirits, no swap out. Meanwhile, Thompson's taking his own engagement. So they kill the Tidehunter up in the lane. Thompson almost, in fact, does kill Exotic Deer with the Death Power Shot. Nisha gets something out of this fight, but Penitent Man shall not pass. Husker up onto the hill. Anna is hunting the back lines. So say goodbye, really, to Kingwin. That's them done in this winner's bracket, in this upper bracket.
Mickey, he's in a little bit of trouble here. Oh, they can't get him in time. Tiger being chased on too, though. The pounce board does connect along with the cast. The RP from Seb catching on the two. Skyrath in a lot of trouble, and so is Nyx. He's gone. Boxy getting super low on HP as they run down from the focus fire. It's too damn high. He'll die. Mickey trying to move in. Needs to be careful. He just blink forward. Yule's going to come out. They should have a light strike array available. No, they don't have it. Mickey will make it back with a buyback on Axe. He needs to make a big play here. because they are being ran over in their own base. Jump forward, Cool comes out, and I think a lot of damage. Can you get them low enough is a question. You'll get the dunk, but you lose Koi from return, and now the control from the pounce enables the kill on to this Axe.
He done it once, but overall, yeah, the players do not deny themselves to creeps way too much because of
Koifa. Thompson just got the solo kill in the mid lane. Windrun doing the work, and it's gonna get worse now because Thompson has the phase boots. Meanwhile,
he had
Seb. Yes, he hasn't leveled the skewer, but he's fine. Support comes across. Jerax gonna try and move around here. They want to get him to Tiger. He is deep in here. Can they spot him out? Taking a lot of damage. The Light Strike Array does connect on the Mickey, trying to turn around, do enough damage. No tail out of mana. Mickey almost out of life. Hell hits on the two. Trying to get rid of Jerax here. Stun connects on the Tiger, though. They'll find the kill. Mickey can't join in. It means Insania versus Free right now. And those odds are insane. Mickey blinks in. He gives his life and doesn't even get Jerax. And they'll lose Insania as well. Double kill for Jerax. As they get all three in the top lane. And this... You need to abandon this tri lane now. It's not working. And meanwhile, in the bot lane, Boxy gets jumped onto. Ana gets him.
Is this the time when you want to jump, Nisha? Prophesying tag on top, the double shackle. Perfect from Thompson. Here's the power shot. So, yep, no false promise again. The Huskar will buy back in, and Ana, the send back doesn't actually happen in time. They'll have to actually just burn the Aegis to the Immortal. Thompson a little bit too deep by himself, but the top lane of Rax is gone. Seb finds the kill into the Tyandra in the back line, so no Ravage, no AoE control. The TP out from Seb. Thanks to his BKB, he's protected enough that he does survive. Unfortunately for the VS, it is not the same story. And Enchantress will burn down Ana. Give a little bit of extra Maelstrom proc just to make it work. And Prof is already back to the front lines, feeding into the tier 3 towers just to end this game and get themselves that winner's bracket match. Unfortunately for OG, they went three slots in the EU qualifiers. So they don't go directly through the group stage, and there's only one.
It finally happened.
Hang on. He died?
They were sending him back with Chen, but he got purged by Oracle. In the slide.
I like that.
Okay, Perch was the least impressed ever by that. Understandable.
It's disgusting you turned that into a unintentional pun. Like I did not.
Combo.
Oh, we got silenced. Good Gust on the back line.
Got him. And maybe gonna look for some more here. They buy back on the Zeus though immediately. He does still have ultimate in 8 seconds if they can wait that long. Nagi, you better get back to the well, because otherwise you might go down here. As they, well, just kill him off with Ana nonetheless.
Oh, he lost the Aegis.
Oh, Purge. This is a pretty good time for it. Can they kill him off in time? The Sleight of Fist trying to get away. It's not going to be enough. And now he's got the bottle. They've got the RP chasing them all down. And with five heroes in the grave, that might be about curtains.
All right, still no game over 28 minutes.